In Asian superhero news submitted by Tears of Joy, Simu Liu, did I say that right?
Mm-hmm.
Will be playing the first ever Asian Marvel superhero, Shang-Chi. Did I say that right?
Shang-Chi.
I didn't even know this character.
Thanks for correcting it.
Out of all the people to correct me, you?
I know, right?
These fucking white people drive me crazy.
A Shang-Chi latte.
That's... can we redo that? I'm gonna get eaten alive.
Nah, they love you. They don't care.
Nobody honestly, cares. Though, I didn't even know. So thank God that you did the first mistake. I was about to do it, too. I was like, damn.
Yeah, so Simu was recently announced as the very first Asian Marvel superhero.
Yay, he's been on here.
I'm so jealous of this motherfucker.
Why?
I want to be in a Marvel superhero.
You gotta audition!
What are you doing to even put yourself on the radar?
I post on Instagram.
Out. He posts on Instagram and him working out in the gym and stuff. Yeah.
I saw what the character looks like, though. I don't
what
think
is the character?
The character? See, I didn't even know who this character
Nobody
was.
Nobody knows who the fuck
yeah,
this
but
is.
Then I had to look it up, and it's basically
with
like...
love.
No, seriously, like, I didn't even know Marvel had an Asian character, but then his superpower is he can, like, duplicate himself.
Is it this guy?
Yeah, and then he has, like, a lot of martial arts skills. Yeah.
Listen, bro. I'm very happy for the guy. But yeah, this is like Guardians of the Galaxy, when that got announced, I was like, what the fuck is that?
But that movie blew my mind.
No, of course, that movie was dope.
Yeah.
But when you
that
go
wasn't
into
a thing people knew about before that movie came out.
Dude, maybe two people did. Know. People can fucking relax about how they knew about Guardians of the Galaxy.
They're a fucking geek, they knew.
Yeah, if they were like a turbo comic book geek, they would know.
Nobody fucking knew.
No one knew, yeah.
So when Guardians of the Galaxy came out, it was like word of mouth. Everyone was like, hey, this is actually tight, and that's why it did really well.
Yeah.
Plus, you just put Marvel on something.
This guy's our friend, and I'm really proud of him, because I was in Toronto like a few weeks ago, and then he was telling me, he didn't get the role yet, and then he was just telling me how it's been like a 6-month auditioning process.
Wow.
Yeah, so he had to do like a couple of screen tests, like moving tests, choreography tests, blocking tests. He had to do like martial arts, and then he had to do like reciting lines. Then he was telling me that his character is really cool. Actually, I don't even know if I could talk about this, but fuck, I don't give a fuck. But he was just saying that what he likes about his character is the character doesn't know he's badass in the beginning of the script. He kind of gets his way there, he finds out, kind of like Spider-Man.
Yeah.
So in terms of being an actor, like there's a lot to sink into and dig into versus like a Superman where you're already like all powerful. So like as an actor, there's not too much you can pull from it. So I thought it was pretty
cool. That's not fucking Superman, dude, but that's fine. That's fine, you wouldn't think that.
He like already had to know martial arts?
Yeah, they were, so they did like a bunch of people audition and then so they had to see that you can already move well.
That's crazy. I feel like Chris Pratt didn't need to have any fighting skills to get that role.
Yeah, wouldn't they find like a stunt guy?
That role is that he's a fucking idiot.
Oh. I see why you got cast.
Yeah.
And also when you're Asian in Hollywood, they're extra racist towards you. So if you're an Asian and you don't know martial arts, they for sure wouldn't cast you.
Yeah, they're like, what's wrong with you?
Yeah, they're like, you're not even a real Asian.
Do you know martial arts?
Yeah.
He really does though.
I'm just trying to get you to be the next Marvel superhero.
Yes. So does he.
Get the word out.
I know. It's funny, I think there's like Asians that deliberately try not to do these stereotypical things, but then we're still attracted to it, so I can't deny it anymore. I just
and it's our ticket in, we have to.
Yeah.
He says with chopsticks in front
of
him.
I know.
Fucking amazing.
In the fucking back scratcher.
Back scratcher, chopsticks in some soy sauce right in front of my face. Damn, I can't run away from this stuff, man.
That's so funny. But yeah, so the other actors announced is Tony Leung and Awkwafina.
Oh, yeah. Damn, Awkwafina's killing the game.
Wait. I've seen that guy on the top somewhere.
He was in The Mood for Love. He's a Hong Kong actor.
He's in Infernal Affairs, original Departed. Okay.
So what's interesting about this movie is that it's setting up what I think is going to be Marvel's unveiling of the Mandarin, who is a huge villain, who is very known.
Isn't his character based off of that Fu Manchu kind of guy or whatever?
Chinese.
Right.
Yeah.
So. This character was they created a protagonist because they came out with an antagonist first, which was this like evil fucking Chinese wizard guy. And then they created Shang-Chi to be like the protagonist.
Shang-Chi.
Yes, get your dialect right, okay?
Like
that's how we say it in LA.
What I'm jealous of though is like, okay, Simu got the role. That's
you're always
tight.
A fucking Asian hater.
No, so that's cool.
I'm jealous too.
But here comes the butt.
But
always, man.
But you know how like as soon as someone lands a role, they immediately sign like a few others. Like, Awkwafina just gets it, right? How come they don't attach me to the project immediately?
Because you're not, they don't even know that you want this project.
Don't they watch JK News?
Bart, they go to your Instagram and you're deadlifting weights. What are you talking about, man? Nobody's going like, hey, this guy's acting out there.
You know what we need to do? For the rest of this year, we need to have them in a Shakespeare like outfit and fucking.
That's just for your own personal comedy.
Holding a skull with the fucking Shakespeare.
You need to show people you got chops, man. Acting chops.
I don't have chops. That's the problem.
You need that Shakespeare dog cone around here.
Yeah. Shakespeare dog cone.
I don't have acting chops. I want to be that guy in a movie that already made it, and people go, man, that guy fucking sucks at acting, but I don't give a fuck, I was in the movie.
You want to be The Rock?
You want to be a Megan Fox? Yeah.
But The Rock put himself out there when he was wrestling. That was all acting.
True.
Because it's fake.
Everybody knows wrestling's fake.
Who everybody?
What do you just think you did?
The pain's not fake.
That's true. That's very true.
But the drama might be, a little bit.
You see, I'm talking to his type.
I get it.
Wait, so how do you guys know Simu?
Just Asians and know each other somehow. So, for real.
I've been a fan because
wasn't it through Wong Fu?
I don't think so.
I forgot how we got in contact with him, but we've been a fan since Kim's Convenience on Netflix. He's a star on that show.
Yeah.
And then we said, come on our show. And he's like, okay.
Damn, do you think he'll come back on?
Yeah. No, he might be too famous now.
Do you think he's gonna watch this? Watch you guys talking about it?
Yep.
Yeah.
He's pretty narcissistic.
Stupid.
Everyone is. If I got famous for something, I'm watching every single fucking video.
Google
commentary.
Alerts. Yep. I'm not famous and I have a Google alert on my name.
See?
I didn't even know you could.
I do that right now too, girl.
Oh my god, Google alert. You could do Google alerts for your name?
How do you guys not know this? You can see it when people are stealing your videos.
What?
You can. Yeah. That's the biggest one. It's just you're like who's ripping your shit.
If you're actually famous, you don't need this. That's the thing. Cause like Jeff Bezos,
you think, what are you trying to say about her?
Well, no, it's no offense.
I said it.
No, I'm just saying, like, you think Jeff Bezos is like, I got Google alerts on my shit, and his phone just blows up.
His PR team has Google alerts on his name.
I thought it was Bezos.
It is. He's probably fucking with you.
I don't even know what it is.
Bezos?
I have no fucking idea.
What language is that?
Bezos. Screwing up names today. Yeah.
How is it spelled?
At least I know what Shang-Chi is. Fuck all you guys.
Oh,
Bezos.
And I know what the Mandarin is, and I know about the Mandarin's 10 rings, but nobody gives a shit about
what are his 10 rings? I don't know anything about his.
Yeah, talk about the 10 rings.
They're all different powers.
They got different powers on them.
God damn it.
So
I had to look it up too. I don't know much about this.
I just found
character.
Out yesterday. I don't know.
I'm just happy we have an Asian superhero. I think that's tight.
That's amazing.
And he's not a bitch.
Yeah.
That's the biggest one. Cause when they were gonna make an Asian superhero, I thought it was gonna be like a nerd with like, I don't know, like a camera.
And the roles are changing, like a doctor.
Yeah, the roles are changing a lot. And he ended up saying at Comic-Con, like, cause we were just talking to someone that yesterday that was there when they announced this, and like Simu mentioned something like, I'm just glad I'm not a doctor.
Oh, shut up, really?
Yeah, in the movie.
But that's a good stereotype, dude.
But that's not every Asian. Like, you probably want to kick ass.
No, I want to be a doctor. I'm just not good enough. That's why I'm a fucking clown. I'm useless. That's why I'm doing this.
Wait, you want to be a doctor in real life?
If I had the discipline, I would do it, but I can't study, so I can't do my homework.
You do study.
I just gravitated toward class clown.
I think I'm just talking about movies, that's all. Like, you don't want to be a badass.
We don't have to get that deep.
This is how spoiled Asian actors are. Fucking Middle Eastern guys right now are like, at least I'm not a terrorist. I got cast in something, mom. Yeah, and you guys are like, oh, I'm not a dentist, thank God. Fucking unbelievable.
Oh, in a movie.
You fucking guy.
Spoiled fucking people.
I want to be a doctor, like, I want to be a surgeon, like, I want to be someone dope, you know?
Wait, it sounds like this is, like, in real life, Joe.
Yeah, you're making it sound
we're just talking about movie roles.
No, yeah, like, I want a doctor role. Like, I don't want to be, like, I don't know.
You don't want to be, like, forcing the word role? Yeah.
I don't know, I don't want to be a homeless guy, like,
I just love the idea of an Asian actor who's been working so hard, right? And he goes home after a long day of auditioning, and they call him, and they're like, you got the role, you're playing the doctor, and he hangs up and he cries, and he's like, stereotype. Meanwhile, this Middle Eastern cat, they're like, hey, just open the briefcase, it's got a lot of wires, and like, just be like, yes, this is perfect.
I think I'm not allowed to laugh at this.
Oh, it's fucking unbelievable.
Like, I hope they don't cut to me at any point in this video just laughing about
It's okay, it's okay. Yeah, we give you the laugh
this
card.
This is a fun place.
You know what? We just had this other actor on Mike Bo Shows, right? And then he played a doctor in like three different roles.
that he had.
But he was a hot doctor in one of them, and he was so happy.
Oh, no.
He was a love interest.
Yeah. Yeah. And he played a doctor for like 3 different roles.
The Asian wise man stereotype is a fun one, too. Where it's like, if you're an older Asian actor, you're only gonna teach people.
Yeah. Right. Like the Mr. Miyagi. Mm-hmm.
With the fucking
the Yoda.
Yes.
With the mustache and the Yoda. And then the...
See, man, I can't run away from these stereotypes because I can't wait till I'm old and people believe every fucking thing I say and I sound like a fortune cookie. Like,
right?
I'm gonna develop an accent and I'm gonna just like tell people.
You sound like
shit.
That now.
I know, but then it's gonna look better when I'm old and I have a long beard with a little bit of hair coming out of the mole. Yep. And like, everyone's gonna believe everything that I say and I'm gonna develop like a cult and there's gonna be all these white people that follow me.
Yep.
That's gonna be fucking amazing.
You know what though? You should speak it into existence too, because Simu actually, he tweeted out last year, he said, okay at Marvel, are we gonna talk or what? Hashtag Shang-Chi.
That's true.
Shang-Chi.
I know, I'm kidding. And then he says, thanks for getting back to
me.
No, you said it right, they're fucking with you.
It's Shang-Chi's?
No. Chi.
Chi.
Yeah, but you guys are fucking it up and going Chai.
So let's not forget who fucked it up first, okay? Give him credit where credit is due. Credit.
Do you know how tight it is to alley-oop yourself a year later?
That is pretty fucking tight.
Fucking all the way across the court, and then a year later you fucking dunk it in. Like, that is sick, dude.
He's got a big dick
that
energy.
That is big dick energy.
That reminds me of the time when I hit up Del Taco and they hit me back.
I don't think it's the same, Joe.
And you know what? That's also big pussy energy, because I'm being fair.
For some reason, I don't like big pussy.
Shouldn't it be like tight pussy energy?
Oh, tight pussy energy. I like that. Yeah. I like that. Sorry.
Loose pussy energy.
Maybe deep pussy.
Deep
energy.
Pussy. Yeah.
No, guys don't like deep pussies.
That's true. That's true.
Little dick guys don't like deep pussy, right?
That's fucking true. Funny.
Oh.
Anyways, I think this is pretty awesome though. Just it's been a long time coming. I think it was this is kind of cool because like 5 years ago, the only roles we had were liquor store owner, laundromat owner, fucking doctor, yeah. And now we could play
karate
different roles. Karate specialist, which I don't want to take away, by the way. I like that role.
Just want more diversity.
But yes. Well, how do you feel about the fact that it's an Asian superhero?
That does kung fu?
That they cast, no, like they, it wasn't just like a non-specific role lead. Like it had to be, oh, this is an Asian lead, finally got a part in a Marvel movie because the character's Asian, instead of just like, hey, here's a really badass character. Yeah, we don't know what race it is. Let's cast this badass Asian we know.
For sure.
Asian Spider-Man, where's my Asian Spider-Man?
I think it's just it's like steps to a ladder. Like we have to, this is probably gonna lead into that one day.
I was telling Joel earlier this week that what kind of sucks about, so this is awesome, this whole project is awesome, but like when Black Panther came out, since the whole black community came up together, you have the Black Panther character, and then you have Kendrick Lamar and The Weeknd make the actual song for them. So with this one, it's gonna be like Jason Chen or like David Choi making like the theme song or whatever, if we wanna keep everything.
Which will suck.
Which will suck at, because they're just folk singers. So I'm like, we need to have like a strong, we need the whole community to come up, so the whole.
Who's the director on this? Is it?
An Asian guy? I don't know. Ang Lee? They should bring Ang Lee?
No, it was that guy that,
Oh, the one that's actually on this
one? Yeah.
I do have
because the Black Panther had a
black director?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I also think we're evolving as a community within America because, you know, the black culture has a really long, rich history of art in America and how much they've already developed and contributed. Where us, it's still something new.
Who's that famous piano player or cello player? Let's get him to make this.
Fucking Yao Ma or whatever?
Yeah. Yo-Yo Ma.
Yo-Yo Ma!
Let's get Yo-Yo Ma on this project too.
All right.
Hopefully, they just get a good someone who's good at it.
Yeah.
From everything you've pitched so far, it sounds terrible.
Right.
Like Asian folk singers and Yo-Yo.
Well, this is supposed to be our Black Panther. The whole package got to be Asian.
Yeah.
Jesus.